It's my number one podcast. And this podcast is a session with a man who has had a lot of experience working on the Uber platform. A man who is currently the managing director of the OOL Vehicle Laundry Services. Most importantly, my brother and the most handsome son of my mother. Playing shortly is a recording of my conversation with Mr. Oamen Itoya. And I really hope everyone out there looking to start working on the Uber platform would find this useful and interesting.
All right. So my first question is, how flexible is Uber? Like when you're working with Uber, when you're driving for Uber, do you have control of your time? Can you wake up anytime you want to work? I mean, something like that. How flexible is Uber?
Yeah, I have control of my time. And it all depends. If you're the owner of the car, fine. And if you're not the owner, you need to work so that you can pay the owner of the car. If you're doing the rentals with the owner of the car. But if your personal car, you have... So anytime you feel like going out, you go out.
Okay, basically, so there's no constraint, like you must wake up 8 and... All right, very good. So, the other question I have here is, at some point, Uber was saying you can make up to 20,000 naira per hour. Is this possible?
No, it's not possible. All right.
So, now, a funny one. What strange things can happen with people you bring into the car? I mean, things like people vomiting in your car and all that.
Yeah, sometimes you see your rider sometimes even want to have sex in the car.
Oh my god.
You know, some will want to smoke, not even a nice cigarette. But I'm talking about India Air.
Oh my god.
You see different kind of crazy things on the platform.
Wow. So anybody planning to do Uber should be open to a lot of things happening.
Yes, of course.
Should be open to a lot of things. So do we get bonus from Uber? Like when you're working with Uber, do you get any bonus kind of?
Yeah, you get bonus. Depends. You know, it's not every day, it's not every time bonus, but it's maybe once in a week. Depends if you can meet up the target for the week, then you might get the bonus. And it depends, maybe the bonus might go like if you can do like 30 trips or 20 trips in a week, then they will reduce their charges, because Uber charges 25%. So they can reduce their charges to like maybe 15%. Their commission rather. So
Uber charges 25% of any amount you make.
Yes.
Wow, that's quite big.
Yes.
That's quite very, very big. Okay, so once you make this amount of trips, then they can reduce the commission.
Yes.
So that's the bonus.
Yeah, that's the bonus. Wow.
So I also heard that there are ratings on Uber. Like there are some ratings you must have to be able to continue riding.
Yes.
Is this true?
Yes. You know, you have to have your 5-star rating, and it depends, because the normal standard of the rating is 5-star. You know, you meet different type of human being on the platform. Some will just tell you like, ah, Oga, this is your air freshener, they show up.
Oh my god.
Oga, remove your air freshener. And why some people will be like, Oga, this is your car, it's too stuffy. Can't you get the freshener?
So, oh my god.
You know, it's not dealing with people, it's not
easy
to deal with people. So you just have to take it. So from there, some will rate you low, some will give you a bad comment, and some will rate you fine. You know? So that's just it.
So, but this rating, there's nothing you can do to go and control it. There's nothing you can do.
There is nothing. Sometimes you might get blocked by Uber if your rating is low. You know? So, the best best thing you can do is to know how you relate well with your rider, why you talk to them, and after the end of the trip, you tell them to rate you. You know, some will even forget to rate you. They just close the app and like,
yeah.
And if the person don't open the app for like hours or so, the rating will wipe off. So you didn't get any rating from that trip.
Does it affect you?
Yes.
Wow.
It does.
Wow. All right. So, is there any point in time where Uber gives vehicle to people interested in working for Uber?
Like, yes.
Like, do they give vehicles, like,
okay, vehicles
for people? Maybe you pay instrumentally for Uber themselves.
No. Usually, when you meet individual person that wants to do the business, so some will go to Uber, like, get enough cars, maybe like 10, 20 cars, and put it under Uber Care. So from there, well, I believe on that platform they do what's called mentors.
Okay.
It's just the normal individual outsider people that get a car and give it to you on higher purchase, or sometimes mentors.
Okay, so not Uber themselves.
No,
so people take cars to Uber and all right. Yeah, all right. So the last question I want to ask is, do you have any advice for anybody looking to start this Uber thing? Because it seems to be very trendy now. So any advice for anybody looking to start?
Yeah, actually, the only advice I can give is that if you have your own personal car, it should be more better than doing a rental or taking an hire purchase too. Because if you're doing a rental with someone, you have to meet up and pay on time. If not, the owner will retrieve the car from you. And if you're doing hire purchase, at the same time, you'll be the one to fix the car at the same time, then pay the owner of the car. And sometimes the disadvantage of doing an hire purchase is that if you're paying and maybe you've paid to a particular amount, and maybe you have issues or something, because obviously there will be issues doing along the line. So if you're not able to meet up, the owner will take the car from you and you will run at loss. So that's just the advice I can give.
Okay, so are there also challenges that people can face when doing Uber?
Yes, challenges? Yes. We're talking about the safety aspect now, because obviously you don't know who you're picking. You pick up random people, and the safety, you know, like for example, I have a friend that got robbed, you know,
right.
Along the line, the car was being stolen from him at the gunpoint. Then, but thank God, we found the car in Abeokuta due to tracker
on
the car. So there is advantage and disadvantage.
That's true. Okay, thank you very much. It's also good to have you. It's also nice to have you. And what really struck me here, was when you said Uber charges 25%. Mm-hmm. But there's this technology that is coming now with which we can do away with Uber, and it's the blockchain. Okay, so it's coming very soon, and I think with it, people can ride freely without these commissions. So thank you very much for having me. It's an honor. Thank you so much. You want to say anything?
No. Mm-hmm, I'm fine.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you too.
Yeah.
That is a recording of my conversation with Mr. Oamen Itoya, and I really hope you enjoyed it. For those of us looking at working at the Uber platform, I know you've done your research and you've done a lot of work and you've put in a lot of things together. But these questions I asked are some of the things you might most likely neglect. And so I have done my own due research and I have been able to combine them, and I hope you find them very useful. If you have questions for Mr. Oamen Itoya, you can leave them in the comment section. And also, most likely, I'll be very excited to see how the blockchain is going to come in to solve the problems of 25% charges on Uber. But till then, let's get back to work. Let's keep working. And let's keep doing things right. Thank you. If you like the content and you want to see more, do well to like this video and subscribe to this channel. Thank you for supporting me.